Okay guys, just before we kick off the video, I just want to let you know that I have a few companions, so they'll be the only spoilers in this video. Just the companions, no other story details. Hey guys, welcome to another video. My name's Chris from TwiiistVideos, and what I wanted to show you today is Fallout 4 and my settlement, my home base that I've put my heart and soul into. Right guys, welcome to Sanctuary Hills. This is the place I've chosen for my main base. It is the greatest city in all of the Fallout universe, and I want to show you around. So there's so many things you can do with this game. Everyone's like base is going to look completely different. So this is what I've done. Obviously the bridge here, this is the main way in and out of the area. So what I've done is I've got two guard posts left and right with two guards on top. We got some spotlights there as well, and of course we have the turrets. And we also have currently one turret out there resting on a wooden platform. I will have another one soon, but I ran out of the materials. So this is the entrance. I didn't want to put a gate in here for this reason. This is obviously a caravan, trader caravan, and if I was to put a gate there, this little guy would struggle and the owner wouldn't come in. Just let that pass, big old beast. Which is awesome. So I have 11 settlers, which attracts traders and also the news robots, you know, the ones that fly around. So I get like little hints and tips, and I get a little bit of quest info as well from these the flying robots, which is awesome. Now I have myself an artillery gun, and that is currently being manned as well. I only put this up literally a few days ago in terms of game time, so there's not an awful lot around. It gets very dark, but it means if I'm close by, I can throw down my my smoke grenades and this thing will fire out and it'll save the day basically. So this guy's got a very important job. That's why he's got a shirt and tie on. This obviously Piper guys, if you haven't progressed in the story, you won't know who that is, so we'll just ignore her for now. But she's a good companion to have, believe me. So what I've done, guys, is I obviously used a lot of materials to build this place. So pretty much all of the houses that you see here are pretty much stripped bare. There's a couple I haven't touched because I just didn't need to. But like, if you have a look in here, I've pretty much picked them clean and started building. So if we head up the road, this road eventually will have plenty of lights leading up to it. But this is the start of the main base. So I have two guards here, got two sentry guns, and we've got a load of metal. This guy looks like, my hunter actually from Destiny. Probably gonna have rusty armor as well because I haven't played that game in ages. But yeah, this is the main entrance here, guys. So nice and fortified and ready to go. And we've got two little platforms and two little ladders so we can get up. I think I'll probably end up putting more sentry guns up here. But I'll be honest with you guys, I haven't been attacked up here yet, so I don't actually know where they've come from. I've had a few enemies just randomly wander, not an actual attack, but raiders just kind of wander around. And they actually came from that direction. So this side here that you're seeing now, this is very new. This got me paranoid actually. So what I did is I was originally just going to have all this open, like deck everything out, but there's just so many holes in the perimeter. So as you can see, I started blocking them up. Because I just assumed, because over there is the river.
There's a story here. We'll
but behind it over there is open space that enemies can come through. So instead of using the whole area, I started blocking it up. So this is, what side would this be? This would be the northeastern entrance. Again, two sentry guns at the bottom and four across the top. I was really paranoid on this one. Yeah. Originally, guys, this was the house I built. Now, this is a prefab, so this is actually a house that's already pre-made, and I added this little garage thing on the side here. Originally, my power armor was housing here. Looked really good, but I don't know. Inside is just a bit bland. It was very dark, even with like the lighting. And I just didn't like up here. You have to be really careful, like moving around. And I had like my workbench and everything up there. But I've since turned it into a hotel, maybe, if that's what you want to call it. But yeah, so I moved out of here, didn't like it. And I moved back into the original house that you start in at the very beginning of the game, which is this one here. I'll show you that in just a moment. Now, when you first come to Sanctuary Hills, this is the default kind of building. So again, plenty of beds in here because I got a few settlers kitten posters on the wall because everyone's got to feel good in this horrible post-apocalyptic world. Just a ton of beds, to be honest, guys. Not an awful lot. Oh, we have a radio. This was when I was just messing around, figuring out how to build stuff. You know, I built a television and that kind of thing. But yeah, just very, very average. And then we got two scavenger posts here, which I didn't really read much into, but apparently they're pretty good to have. And this will be the latest addition. Now, like I said, I had the very random raiders come walking through. And they came from, I think it was either here or here, one of the two. So I have built a wall across here as well. Now, my farm is currently outside. There's the trough for the, I can't remember what they're called, the cow things. Here is Sean, guys. Again, ignore him if you don't know anything about the story just yet. But this is the farm. Plenty of people working on the farm. He's not a slave master. He's not going to hit them with that sledgehammer if they stop working. It's not that kind of game, not that kind of place. But this is, yeah, we've got corn, we've got potatoes, boil them, mash them, stick them in a stew, and we got melons. The melons were already here, actually, so I just kind of used the area as is. So that's that. And then I think the water pumps, I moved. God damn it, let me out.
Human carry so much. Strong only need hammer. Strong want to smash something.
Cheers for the talk, bud. Oh yeah, I have a basketball hoop up there. No basketball though. You just have to throw aluminium cans in. Actually, no, you won't, because I need those things. No aluminium cans. You can have a tin can. And this is the water pump. Insanely glamorous. Got a great view. But yeah, there's that sentry gun there as well. So yeah, that's kind of the surrounding areas. Now what I want to do is I want to show you the base, the El Presidente, the general headquarters of the Commonwealth, whatever. My house. This is my house. Now, I wanted to move all the companions back here because I just had these random settlers. So, the dog literally just disappeared. How weird is that? Unless he's... Oh, no, there he is. Easy hiding. So I've put his dog bowl. This thing moves on its own accord, but yeah, this is dog meat's little area. He has, what is going on there? Oh my god! I think it's because we're in this. There you go. I always do that. Just drop it. Thank you. It's not the right way out, but it doesn't matter. Yeah, this is little dog meat's little house. He uses it all the time, which is quite cool. Very intelligent AI, actually. Well, he's just, I don't know what he's doing now, but they just use things around them, which is awesome. I don't know whether it's because I put the bowl in front of it that he's struggling to get in, but you get the idea. Is he going to go in? No. We'll see if he's in there later. Can hear something moving.
Yeah?
What is that noise? What is that noise? Okay, something is definitely going on. I'm just going to check the roof. I'm going to see what that actually is. So to get to the roof, guys, we come around the back. Now, I'll use this opportunity to show you the back of the house. So I have, again, I've blocked up all of the entrances and exits, so this should be relatively secure. I've also done the windows as well, because I'm sure you can get shot through them. How did you get out here? You were sitting on that sofa. Silly. So yeah, that's what I've done, and then we've got an entrance at the back here to get onto the roof. Must be the spotlight. Something is making noises. I don't know what it is. I'm just going to move this over because I don't want that to ruin the sound of this video. Oh, she's brave. Right, it's not that. Is it the shelf? Oh, wait. I know what that is. That's the weird space monkey. He's obviously fallen down. Yeah, look at that. Look at this creepy guy I found. I had to bring him back with me. Look at this. Look at the state of that. Let me just put that back and I'll show you. Look at it. Look at it's minging. Let me stand this up. He's got a very shiny face though, but he never usually does that. Yeah, you can stay on the floor. At least you're not making noise that way. Right, so back out here. Yeah, so my fortified guard post with two sentries, two guards, because, like I said, I'm insanely important. I'm the most important person in this game. And I have to be protected because everyone wants a piece of me. So, yeah, that is the outside. Oh, we actually have some water pumps over here as well. I didn't even realise. Yeah. Also, guys, you're probably wondering why this is here. I'll attach a photo now, but for some reason, I don't know how they were getting up here, but all of my settlers were standing on this roof at one point. I don't know whether it was like a glitch or they found a way up, but they wouldn't come down no matter how hard I tried. So what I had to do is I had to put this little ladder here, and obviously they also have problems getting up, but if any of them decide to throw themselves off the roof, at least they can kind of walk down the steps. So that's why that's there, and I actually kind of like it. Right, so if we go through here, it is now. It's a bit dark. I will turn the lights on in just a moment, but what I have, actually, I'll tell you what, guys, let's wait until nighttime and I'll show you the outside, and then I'll show you the inside as well, because it'll be all lit up and it will all look pretty. So I'll see you in a second. Right, guys, now the sun's gone down, let's go and have a little peek inside the headquarters of, I don't know, I don't really have a name, but here we go. So, living room, very basic. We have two shelves. I haven't really put anything on them just yet. We've got a radio there, a television. This is a really good channel, guys, check it out. It's amazing. Just Please Stand By, really, like, really interesting, very, very entertaining. The monkey from earlier on, Mr. Jangles. Look at the state of that. Like, seriously, look at the state. I just want to shoot it. I'm not going to, though. Don't want to alarm my citizens. You can stay there. Yeah, you can chill out on the couch, on the sofa, whatever you want to call it. With a decent door as well. Now, kitchen. Usually, there is a ton of Nuka-Cola in here. Generally, I tend to put them in here, but I needed them all because I went to fight. I won't tell you, but it was a rather large enemy, so I wanted all the Nuka-Cola. A few lights. We got the fan here. We got the hanging light as well, which is cool. I blocked up the side because, again, I just wanted to one entrance in and out, and the guards are there as well. My bobblehead stand, I currently have two. That's all I found, but I love having this thing. It's like showing off your collectibles. So I have the repair and the science, and there's quite a few to go. So hopefully the next video, this will be a lot more full. And then we have the magazine stand. Originally, I had the silver spin one, but for some reason, it would never face forward. And I kind of wanted to check out what I had. So we got lots of grognak. Guns and bullets. We have a Wasteland survival guide there. Obviously, a lot of those in the Fallout series, and Hot Rodder and all that kind of stuff. So I'm probably going to need quite a few of these, but hopefully we'll have a nice big bookshelf here at some point. Everything else is a bit barren this side, but I will get lots of stuff on there. Obviously lit up the hallway, just normal lights. In here, this is my legendary item case. I didn't want to mix them in with the normal stuff, so, you know, we got a few bits in here. VAT's enhanced switchblade, it's quite interesting. And I got a cane, which, yep, don't really know what I'm supposed to do with that, but I've got it anyway and I'm going to keep it in there. Great shower, cold water, glows green when it comes out, it's awesome. And this is my storage area. Now, I just got random crap in here, to be honest, guys. I haven't really sorted this out, but You know, got my jet supply for my addiction. Potatoes, boil them, mash them, stick them in stew. And I think I've... I don't know what's in here, actually. It's the same sort of stuff. Cram, bit of dirty water. I got Fat Man in there, which is quite cool. Guys, Fat Man, I believe, was the second bomb that was dropped in the World War, I think. I think that was the name of it. And then we have... this is actually a window. This isn't a painting. This is a window. This is the last green area you'll ever see. This is also a window. On the other side of this wall, there's an ocean. Not paintings. I had a load of toys on me, actually, the last time I did this. So I just threw them into the crib. A bit creepy. Jangles? Oh, I think I've... Okay, I've either got two of these, or there's some paranormal activity stuff going on right now, and he's just like hiding under the bed. Oh my god, he's twitching. Was he twitching, or was that just an illusion? Anyway, and I've got a little toy alien thing here as well. So this is the bedroom, you sleep there, nothing in there. Lots of leaves, couldn't afford carpet, so I just swept leaves in here. And this is the workbench. Now, I love this place because... I only just started using these weapon and armor workbenches, and they're so good, guys. Make sure you put your skill points into this, because your weapons go from doing horrible pitfall damage to actually doing a fair chunk, which is awesome. That's everything. Yeah, that's everything for inside, guys. You know, so I will be featured on MTV Cribs at some point, if that show even still exists. But I'm working on it. It's a work in progress. I need to get some lights. I have the lights here, but I ran out of the wiring and the conduct. What do you call it? Whatever these things are called. You know, the things you put the wire on. To light them up. But I got a generator here and a generator over the back. The generator here is the one that lights up this side. That generator. Where are we? This one goes to here, which then goes off into the house. Oh yeah, I have a spotlight at the top as well. It's not really going to do much up there, but it'll look cool. I got a radio beacon up there as well, which attracts more settlers. And then we have a pylon going this way for when I eventually do something in this scary, unsecure area over here. And then last but not least, my favourite bit of this, which is why there's so many lights and I tried to make it look all cool, is the power armour housing. Hey, there you go, he's chilling. Hey mate, how you doing? Yeah, the power armor. As you can see, it's again work in progress. I've got winterized bits and pieces, and then I've got a normal T45 helmet. I've got T51 gear on there, but it's a work in progress. But I love it. But it looks so cool in here. It looks really, really cool. So one of my favorite bits about this area, obviously, that's the door into the kitchen. And this will be where I store all of the power armor items, things like fusion cores if I have to, and all the armor that I find, because, you know, why not? And I'll block this area up as well. Yeah, we have round here at the back. What I am going to do, I'm going to move the farm and all the water stations around here. So I basically bring the farm into this secure area, because, like I said, currently it's outside of the... of the main walls, and we have settlers who are working there, and they're just going to get murdered and bludgeoned to death by super mutant attackers, raiders, you name it. They're all there. But yeah, that is the home base, guys. So guys, originally I wasn't going to hole up there in Sanctuary Hills. I was actually at the Red Rocket Station. Generally, the only reason I was here because of that automatic door. I love this door in here. Look at it. Whack this little button and you get this awesome little garage door open up. But I don't know, I just felt away from the action. I felt very exposed. I mean, I've got a wall here. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it because it's very dark and I took away a lot of the lighting. But, you know, I had this out here. I had the dog in the corner. Okay, that's one of the settlers working on the other side of the wall. Good job, mate. Keep it up. If you get yourself hit on the head, no problem. And the doors here as well, guys, are pretty cool. They're all, like, automatic doors, which is very cool, very secure. And I do kind of miss it here because it's a bit smaller and you don't have to worry about much. But I felt a lot safer, and I don't know, I just liked having that original house with all the rooms and stuff, you know. It was cool to have. Who is that, actually? That might be Preston. Yeah, it might be Preston. Maybe. But yeah, so guys, that was my home base and a little brief look at my original base. So I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. If you want to comment a link to your home settlement, if you've done a video, please, you may post it in the comment section. I'll definitely check it out. I want to see what all you guys are up to. I know lots of my friends are really looking forward to showing theirs off. But leave the video a like, guys, if you enjoyed it. And I shall see you in the next video. Goodbye. I don't know what I'm doing. Goodbye.